Hi everyone, welcome back. Now that we've got the software installed and logged in, we can show you some charts. But before we do that, I want to go over the general screen layout of the software. There's lots of icons and menu items that are very important. So I want to go over those first before we go into charts and tools. So as you can see, I've opened a chart here, but that's only to show you what some of these icons do. So I'm going to start on the very far left-hand side of the screen. You'll see there's a number of icons, what we call the actions bar. And if we just mouse over, you get a little pop-up telling you what it does. So this top one, this toggles the control panel. So you can see the actions and properties panel on the left-hand side there. We can roll that away to increase the chart space. So just left click once and roll that away so we don't see the actions and properties. Now, we'll go into, later videos, more details, but we can see those actions and properties even though they're rolled away by using the right click menu on the chart. So when we mouse over the right click menu, we get the same menu items as in the actions and properties panel on the left-hand side. But we can roll that away to give us more space. So the next one down is to open a workbook. The one below that is to save. And again, we'll go into workbooks at a later date. This is just to go over all the icons that you have. And the next one is to print. Now, a lot of these icons also have the option to set properties. So we do that by right-clicking on the printer icon in this case, and you'll see that there's all the print settings that we have there that can be adjusted to your needs. Other popular ones are this wrench or spanner. This is the tooltip. So when it's enabled, you can see it's a slightly darker color. This means that when you mouse over a bar, the tooltips or the bar information, high, low, close value, and volume automatically pop up. And if we click that again to turn it off, the tooltips are disabled. Next one is the crosshairs. So a lot of people like to line up charts and tools using the crosshairs. So you can see that label position also tracks where you are on the chart. And again, right click and you can turn off those labels as well so that they're not shown on the chart. And also we can add custom labels using the scripting language, but that's much more advanced and we'll go into that again at a later date. I'll just turn the crosshairs off. Now, I should also mention that all these can be done by creating keyboard shortcuts, and that's in the shortcut menu that we'll discuss later on as well. The padlock, that is the lock cursor to price. And there's an example of a keyboard shortcut, Control L. What that means is when you apply a tool, it will automatically snap to the closest high, low, close, or midpoint of a bar. And you know when it's turned on because you've got a little cross following your cursor. And it just makes it easier to accurately apply trend lines or horizontal lines or any tool rather than having to manually apply it to the correct level. So we can turn that off as well. Grid lines. So that will put grids on the chart background. Again, right click and you've got all the settings there. You can just have price lines shown. You can just have dates. You can change the distance. Everything's customizable. So again, right click on the grid lines for that. One last one I'll show you is the training mode. This probably deserves its own video as well, but basically click the training icon and you can basically go back in time to hide all current bars and put on tools and indicators and then advance the chart without knowing beforehand what actually happened in the price action. So it's a great training tool there to test your theories. And again, I'll click that to turn the training mode off. As we go to the top of the screen, we've got several menu items, file, This is where you can open workbooks and save and publish. New is where we open charts. So again, that's in the next video where we go into the basics of opening different types of charts, watch lists, and scripting tools as well. The next tools icon, this lists all the tools that you have available on your account. Now, I'll have probably most of the modules on this account, so you may see here many more than on yours. But if we click all, you get an alphabetical list of all the technical tools that we have available. And we've grouped them into their own folders as well. So if you want to look at Fibonacci tools, click the Fibonacci folder. And then as you actually mouse over the tool within each folder, you get a little thumbnail and a description on the right-hand side. And even click more information, and that will take you to our online knowledge base to give you more information about that particular tool. Settings, there's lots of settings that you can customize the software, be it colors. So I've got it set to white or light at the moment. We can put everything in a dark theme. Shortcut settings, language, and general workspace settings as well. Again, far too many to go into detail in this video, but there'll be a whole separate settings video later on. The data menu, this is where you can keep track of all the exchanges that you, end of day exchanges that you have added on your account, and also real-time data providers. So this is where you can configure data from IQ Feed or Bloomberg or any of the real-time data providers that we're compatible with. And you can also import data as well, like CSV files and MetaStock format and things like that. And also for professional services clients, we have a market breadth module, which will you can use to create your own custom market breadth studies, and also custom codes, which means you can create your own ticker symbols, such as ratio charts, one ticker divided by another, or an index. And again, more details on that will be forthcoming. Alerts, we can create technical alerts, price alerts, and time alerts. So three different types, which are all possible with the software. Searches menu, that's where we have the scanning manager, the back tester, and the signal tester. So all this is based on our Optuma scripting language. So you don't have to be a programmer to learn how to do that. We already have a number of scripting languages, scripting videos that are available at the learn.optuma.com website. Just sign in there and you can learn all about introduction to scripting, which will pop up a lot because it's a very powerful tool that you can use in lots of different tools and features and areas of the program. And the help menu, that's where you can contact us, the knowledge base. Also, occasionally we require or may require remote support assistance for training or to troubleshoot some issues. So that's down there. Also a change log. Quite often we release program updates and upgrades. So you can go to that link and that'll open up a web page telling you what's new in the latest update as well. Further along on the right-hand side, you can see I've actually got two tabs or two charts open at the moment, SPX and XJO. I'll go into, as I said, opening charts and creating workbooks in another video. But we've got two charts there open at the moment. And these icons on the right-hand side, these allow you to scroll left and right. You can have as many tabs open as you like, but in this example, I've only got two. So you can just either click on the tab, or if you've got lots and lots of tabs open, you can use those arrows. The next icon is page layouts. So in another video, you'll learn how to create your own chart space with layouts. So your own tools, color schemes, time frames, everything that you like to have, we can create, and you can have them applied automatically to charts within seconds. So you don't have to apply them every single time. The next is view pages. So if you've got lots of charts open, you can click that icon and you'll get little thumbnails and you can choose which chart to open that way. We can also cycle through tabs automatically. So you don't have to manually click to move a few tabs. If we right click on that little circular icon, we can set the time, the cycle time. So I've got it set to 5 seconds. So when that's enabled, that will scroll from one tab to the next every 5 seconds. So you can automatically, you can just watch, look at the chart, make any decision, and without staring at it forever, it will automatically move on. And if you do want to stop it and do some more analysis, you can just click the icon to stop. Finally, the search icon, little magnifying glass there. You may have a workbook with 500 charts, and you can type that or click that icon and search on a name of a stock or a ticker symbol. And so if I do SPX, for example, it's going to say it's found a page called SPX and a chart. So we can click on that and it'll take it to that specific page without having to scroll down. One other thing I should have mentioned, those arrows, if you click and hold, you get a big long list of all the ticker symbols that are open. So again, like the search menu, if you've got hundreds of charts open and you don't want to manually scroll left and right or look for the actual chart, you can just click and hold those directional arrows there, and you'll have the list of symbols which you can then click on to select and bring up on the screen. Now finally, the price scale on the right-hand side, obviously you're all familiar with that being Chartists. You can change the settings on that by right-clicking. Pretty much anything in the software, anything you want to change, left-click or right-click, and the properties will come up. That's a general rule of thumb, but it's a great way to learn how to use the software. So I just right-clicked in the price scale properties there, and you can see I've got it set by default. It'll all be automatic price scale. So when you zoom in and out historically, the price scale will adjust. Now, obviously, you can turn that off, so the price scale is set. You can increase the font sizes. So it's especially useful if you publish a lot of charts and you want to make the price scales bigger, you can change the font size. And that's a universal setting, so every chart will be the same. You can change the decimals. So let's just say I want one decimal in this particular chart, and other options are there as well. One last thing I'll mention, in the bottom right-hand corner, you'll notice a little padlock with a ratio. That is the price-time ratio for that particular chart. So a lot of traders using geometry and angles like to use that price-time ratio, and we can lock that so that it stays proportional as you scroll in and out of the chart, so that angles are kept consistent. So that's a brief overview of the general Optuma screen layout. Next up, we will show you how to open charts and apply some tools. Thanks very much.